Hey, Matt 31, I had a question coming off of section 5.3, number 69, and I needed to do this one on my laptop rather than my desktop because I upgraded my operating system last night and things are crashing. So the downside to that is this calculator emulator, it doesn't have a key press history like you've been seeing, but it's the best I got, so I'm going to go with it. So for number 69, it says use your calculator to approximate the local maxes and mins or the global maxes and mins. And so it looks like I've got a quartic here. So quartics look usually like a W. And I say W, but not M, because I have a positively coefficient here of x, a positive one. So both ends are going to be up. So let me hit Y equals. There we go. And then let me go ahead and type in x to the fourth plus x. And I don't know what my last window was, so I'm just going to hit zoom 6. All right, and let's see what we got. Yeah, and so it doesn't quite look like a W because I just have the x to the fourth and the x terms. I don't have the x cubed, the x squared, or the constant. And it's when you add those in that you really start to get the W. But I still have both ends up and what looks like a minimum. And if I kind of zoom in, it looks like that minimum's close-ish to x equaling negative one. So let me go ahead and calculate that by hitting second and trace. And I'm going to do option three. So you can scroll down to three and hit enter, or you can just hit three. And you can move Blinky left and right if you want, but I'm really lazy and want to be efficient. So if I think that x coordinate is around negative one, I think I'm going to go to the left of that. And just plop in, that's not a word, pop in negative two. So if I think the x coordinate of my minimum is negative one, a number definitely to the left of that is negative two. I'll hit enter. And you could also put in negative three, negative four. And if I look here, if I think my x coordinate is negative one or ish negative one, I can go to the right of it. I'm just going to play it safe and go all the way over to positive one and hit enter. And you can see my calculator is going to find the minimum between these two little triangles. You can enter in a guess if you want. I'm not going to. I'm just going to hit enter. And there's my minimum. So it looks like it's about negative 0.63 and negative 0.47. Now, because that is the ultimate lowest point on the graph, not only is it a local minimum or a relative minimum, it's a global minimum as well, because that is the absolute lowest point on the graph. So for this particular function, I have a local min. That is also the global min. I do not have a local max, and I do not have a global max either because this graph goes on up forever. So there's number 69. All right, thanks so much. Bye.